Hello, seafarers. So we're here at the second site of the Damien Hirst exhibition, and I've discovered another sea creature with a very large penis, which is a recurrent theme in the sexualization of the ocean. So we'll just twist so we can see the full glory of the ocean penis man, which I'm not sure is based on myth or whether he's a demon or just really turned on by coral. I suppose only Damien knows. It's quite nice though. I'm not sure I'd like it in my garden. To be fair, it might scare off foxes and burglars and other perverts. Not quite sure what's going on here, but again, I mean, the one thing about this exhibition is the fabrication, mold making, is next to none. It's absolutely incredible what the team have done to achieve these ideas and images, these effigies and sculptures and false idols and myths and creations. It really is. I mean, he's the Christopher Nolan of making stuff on a grand scale. Decided, I just can't hide it. Come on, come on, come on, come on, I want you. Woo! So we are about to enter, which is the scariest room probably in history, which contains some woman trying to defeat, I assume this is the Hydra, fuck off sea serpent, lots of heads which you think you cut them off and they just regrow. This really is tremendously scary. The scale is just, I barely reached the woman's bottom. Bloody, bloody hell. Looks like a king cobra and all his mates, who are not cobras, but nasty fuckers. And then there's a woman. She has six arms. She's probably quite useful in this situation and others. Then we go here, and we have a sort of floral version. Floral version of the same kind of thing. A little bit less scary, really. A little bit more Jean-Paul Gaultier Gucci with the floral patterns and, pardon? Just doing a review of this number. And the woman, she, yeah, sort of similar. Probably the same mold, wasn't it? But yeah, fairly terrifying, but perhaps nicer in one's garden. A little bit Jeff Koonsy, isn't it? With his giant dog. Sorry. Quite, kind of makes you want to go to the bottom of the ocean. Or perhaps in a glass bottom boat, obviously. Because if you weren't wearing shoes, you'd probably sting your foot. Then here is Damien, his manager and assistant, bottom of the ocean, playing around with this thing. Again, probably shot at Pinewood, but as a photographic image, it's fairly tremendous and scary. Certainly cinematic in its scale, its framing and its sort of power as a standalone image. And again, in the corner we have the scary Hydra, which, yeah, we've all had nights out like this, haven't we? Intense. But we live to tell the tale. a shiny gold something. It's very gold inside. So gold. It's like the inside of a wizard's ear. I'm a scat man, bee ba da ba da bum, ba da ba da bum, bee ba da ba da bum, ba da ba da bum, bee ba da ba da bum, ba da ba da bum. I'm a scat man. I mean, imagine if you saw this fucker walking down your street and he was like 20 foot tall. You'd be pretty scared, wouldn't you? Not only is he a robot, but he's like a Bling Harrods robot. So he's probably even more lethal. At least you'd be killed by a very stylish object. That's scary. Look at my tail. Here are quite a lot of gold things they probably found in the bottom of the ocean, or probably said they found them in the bottom of the ocean, which is the whole point of the exhibition. Question the line between truth and a lie, and where that line lies. It's a clever play on words. Here is what looks like the Lion of Judea, maybe a bit of a deep sea Rasta reference with some kind of. So a little update on this whole lion woman thing. It's all to do with an ancient myth about a woman that was blind, but what she lost in human ability, she gained in supernatural ability to have foresight into the future. Perhaps the lion is symbolic of that. Or maybe not. I like her outfit. She's wearing Dior and Fendi. These found or discovered or reimagined news, more emblematic of a new shapely form to the female body, something which was later channeled by the likes of Pablo Picasso and new schools of image makers. The more pert bottom, which if you look from this angle could be a forerunner to the Kim Kardashian derriere style, rather protruding arse. Almost like a weapon. Very slim waist. This is, this one's made in China. So he's sort of a joke. Another one of his little private jokes. Move us along. Small breasts. Here we have Uncle Damien and Mickey Mouse. Could this be a reference to us, the audience? Being Mickey Mouse, a little boy, being led around his fantastical farce. We will never know. But he's the rich one. He's not really, you know, he's not Dali, is he? He's not. What's he changed other than the commodification of art and art as an object? I'm not sure it's. Push the envelope in terms of meaningful ideas. He may have pushed it in terms of ideas about value and all that kind of stuff. And it's quite crass, isn't it? It's not that intellectual, really. I mean, it's a lot of it seems to be slightly retrofitted with a kind of a purpose and an aim. I don't think he's a scratch on Jeff Koons in terms of his comment on consumerism and America and. I mean, maybe I'm being unfair, but I don't think I'm the only one who feels his opinions that you are left quite empty and hollow by a lot of these objects. Proteus, the old man of the sea. Proteus famously suffered the betrayal of his own daughter in the Odyssey. Eldorthia informed Menelaus in order to access her father's prophetic powers, Proteus must be prevented from transforming into every sort of beast on earth and into water and blazing fire. Despite the god's impassive countenance,
His sense of physical anguish is alluded to here through his dramatic metamorphosis.
Here we are with the god of getting fucked up, Bacchus, and his mate just getting ready at a rave. Someone has overdosed on fake ecstasy from China, and this is a statue representing that famous overdose. The Minotaur was the offering of a beautiful snow-white bull and the queen of Crete, who was bewitched with an uncontrollable lust for the animal as punishment for her husband disobeying the gods. Confined to a subterranean labyrinth, the Minotaur, who had endured as a potent symbol of the threat of male lust and sexual violence, feasted annually on the tributary flesh of young men and women sent from Athens. Big pair of balls. So we are standing outside the something, and we've just finished both exhibitions. And what are my thoughts? Well, I haven't left feeling particularly inspired by the work, but maybe that's not the point. I had a brief conversation with one of the security guards, and she confirmed what I was already told, that everything in the exhibition in terms of the deep sea wreckage and all that is absolutely fake. But the whole nature of Damien Hirst's work is to put two fingers up to the public and say, this is costing 50 million, you're all a bunch of yourselves. Whereas Dali and other artists, other people that are a lot, you know, they were about ideas, weren't they? So what's Damien's ideas? But on the plus side, there are lots of interesting visualizations of Greek tragedy, stories from mythology, and that's quite nice, bringing it to a wider audience. And some of it was very pretty. And on the plus side, all the fabrications and sculptural work was incredible. So whoever made those, you guys are amazing. Keep on doing your job. And I'm glad that they're able to do a job on such an epic scale. So, yeah. Thank you.